Prometheus Books, an imprint of Globe Pequot, presents Battlefield Cyber, How China and Russia Are Undermining Our Democracy and National Security, by Michael G. McLaughlin and William J. Holstein. Read by Steve Menasche. Introduction. All hands on deck. It was a moment of supreme geopolitical drama. Chinese President Xi Jinping took advantage of the opening of the Winter Olympics in Beijing in February 2022 to greet Russian President Vladimir Putin. Together, they declared that they would start a deeper pattern of cooperation with one another with no limits. Even though deep mutual distrust persists, they have found common cause in challenging the supremacy of American democracy and democracies throughout the world. Putin's invasion of Ukraine and China's brazen military pressure on Taiwan are the two primary manifestations of their testing of America's alliances with other democracies. But there is a deeper, perhaps even more malicious strategy afoot, one that is much less visible. China and Russia are each exploiting cyberspace and all the digital highways the United States has taken a lead in building. The interests and methods of these two authoritarian regimes appear to be aligning. Increasingly, they are attacking the very foundations of our democracy and national security. As Americans, we thought we had created the technology of the Internet and therefore would dominate and control it. But these adversaries have learned how to penetrate American systems for espionage, data and intellectual property theft, and criminal gains, and how to position themselves for future cyber attacks against our critical infrastructure. Unlike Western democracies, which closely adhere to international norms in cyberspace, these adversaries understand cyberspace for what it truly is, a battlefield. The rise of the Internet and social media has changed the way nation-states compete and altered the very definition and boundaries of war. As technology advances, its use generally becomes safer. But ironically, our increasing reliance on sophisticated information technology and communications networks has made us more vulnerable rather than more secure. The Internet is one of the biggest technological changes in human history, on par with the printing press and the steam engine. While Americans have been excited by new possibilities, our rivals have been quicker to understand the total nature of the new competition the Internet has ushered in. The battlefield is not limited to network penetrations. Our opponents have also mastered the use of our own social media platforms to deepen the dangerous illusion that different sets of Americans are fighting among ourselves in to-the-death struggles for ideological supremacy. Our adversaries have learned how to fan the flames of ethnic and racial tension and how to either interfere in our elections or cause us to question their legitimacy. They use our own social media platforms to pit our political parties against each other and to sow confusion among our populace about the origins of COVID-19 or the Chinese government's ethnic cleansing of its Uyghur population. They cooperate in promoting Putin's crazed notion that the United States and its NATO allies forced him to invade Ukraine to depose its neo-Nazis. and they do all of this legally. While some narratives are pushed through fake accounts and bots, many are propagated through the expenditure of billions of dollars in advertisements on our social media platforms. Chinese entities, doubtlessly coordinated by the Communist Party and the state, spent $10 billion on Facebook advertisements in 2021 alone. A massive propaganda blitz. The Chinese Foreign Ministry recently boasted that it has published more than 9,000 posts on social media outside China and attracted almost 500 million views. The Chinese government, in particular, is also engaged in a massive campaign of technology theft targeting American companies and organizations. It relies on penetration of American telecommunication and computing platforms to do that, in combination with old-fashioned human espionage. This comes in many forms, from network exploitation by state-sponsored hackers, to predatory investment in U.S. technology startups, to the insertion of backdoors in technology that is made in China and installed in our systems. Technology theft amounts to denying economic gains to the very people whose tax dollars are supporting advanced research in U.S. laboratories and universities. Most Americans do not understand that products developed in China, and the wealth created, accrue to the benefit of China, not the United States. China's multi-pronged approach to reap the rewards from America's technical prowess and innovation places both private sector corporations and U.S. national security in peril. Although our adversaries opt for illicit cyber activities, their strategies have been carefully calibrated to prevent a forceful U.S. military response or cyber onslaught on their own computer systems or critical infrastructure. China and Russia know that if we are galvanized as a nation, as we were by the attack on Pearl Harbor or the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001, we are capable of stunning achievements. That is why they pursue a long-term numbing strategy, not sudden and obvious assaults, such as shutting down the electrical power system of Washington, D.C. If we are waiting for a cyber Pearl Harbor or a cyber 9/11, we are fatally misunderstanding how our adversaries wage cyber warfare. The Russians have been willing to walk right up to the line of what would be considered an act of war, and the United States has caught them in the act. In a stunning indictment in March 2022, the U.S. Department of Justice accused one member of the Russian Ministry of Defense and three officers of Russia's Federal Security Service of penetrating critical energy infrastructure in multiple countries, including a nuclear power plant in Kansas. There was no purpose behind this type of activity other than to preposition cyber weapons for a future attack. In an open conflict scenario, Russian hackers could turn a small town in Kansas into the next Chernobyl. These types of attacks and penetrations are not one-time occurrences. Simply put, our adversaries have graduated from the occasional assault targeting individual companies and agencies, and now have established a permanent presence in America's computers. The experts call this persistent access. And it appears from recent software supply chain attacks that our opponents can lurk inside some of our systems for years without being detected. According to a defense intelligence source, The Russians make more noise, which is why they get caught, but the Chinese are...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.